All right, so nobody likes a long, drawn out YouTube intro, so here are the important parts. We're in Kernersville, North Carolina. This trail is the Kernersville Mountain Bike Park. It's about 3.5 miles if you do all the little improvements. The reason I like this trail is because it's got about 9 miles worth of obstacles and interesting things crammed into about 3.5 miles. It's a blast. So once this car goes by, we're gonna go ahead and get started and you'll see how it goes. What I love about this trail is right off, you've got something going on. Right into the turns. Hard switch back here at the end of the beginning. And then straight into a berm. Ride that around, another berm. Now these guys at the Kernersville Cycling Club have been fantastic. They're out here all the time making improvements or just regular trail maintenance. And it keeps it awesome. Whoops, a little bit of a mistake there. Just take care of that in editing. That's it for today. Appreciate you watching. Starting to rain, so I figured I'd shoot some throwaway footage. Man, I love this trail. That was close. Need a little more speed. Hey, not bad for my first time doing the drop on my 29er, huh? get that heart rate down, shall we? You ain't sliding, you ain't riding. Coming up on the part that made me fall in love with this place 2.5 years ago. Here it is. First time I caught air off of that thing on my old Trek 4500 hardtail, I was stuck. There was no way I could go without riding. This trail had hooked me. Airtime. Love that jump. Of course, if I'm trying to beat my Strava time, I bunny hop that sucker and just keep pedaling. Top tip for you guys trying to catch up to the speed demons like Randy Proctor and Silas Swaim and the other guys. Not me. That's just my one little trick. I'm still slow. Oh, I can't forget Migs Miguel out there either. Or Luis Sanchez, those two guys. And all the videos they post. Great stuff. Matter of fact, there is a great recording of Mr. Migs Miguel riding this trail at about the
pace I typically ride it, which is probably faster than today because I'm pretty tired from yesterday's ride. If you're seeing raindrops, don't worry. I'm not tearing up the trail today. It's just a light little spitting, I would call it. And obviously, we don't ride on this trail when it's wet. Out of respect for the Kernersville Cycling Club and all the fine members that work so hard on this trail. If it does start to rain, you can bet, because it's happened to me before, I will cut this ride short and most likely walk it out when it turns to soup. It's already getting a bit slimy. Might see a couple of two-wheel drifts. Definitely starting to rain a little bit more today. So I had this elaborate plan. It's New Year's Day, 2017, and got this GoPro for Christmas and have another digital camera that shoots in 1080p. And of course I've got an iPhone, which to me sounds like a three camera setup. Well, recorded most of the first downhill, only to find out that my wide angle camera was set to the wrong mode and all the footage was useless. So I had to start over. Then I ran out of battery juice. And if I hadn't have run out of battery juice, it looks like I would have run out of weather. So I will have to cut this ride short very soon. So today we'll be skipping those lovely berms. Be a good way to save about 3 minutes, but at least you'll get the rock crossing if you can still see. Yeehaw. We're gonna skip this downhill too because it gets soupy really quick. Oh, there's the new rock crossing that Mr. Proctor was so kind in warning me about the other day. He knows I do a lot of riding out here at night. And that could have very well been a unpleasant surprise. Whew, feeling it today. So yesterday was my first day back riding after 2 weeks off, which those were a terrible 2 weeks too, in that I let my diet go to, well, Hades, if you're sensitive to such words. And let's just say it was a lot of fatty cakes, a lot of candy, and a lot of responsible drinking. Whoop, two-wheel drift. That little root just likes to get beside your tire. Mess you up just enough. Alright, so we're taking the bypass in an effort to save time, going straight into the creek crossing. Now the entrance to the creek crossing coming this way is a lot better. It's just more direct, see? When we drop down into the creek, looks like I'll be visiting the bike shop this week, as my rear derailleur is not quite as dialed in as I want it to be, and I'm afraid it's going to break my chain, because it likes to change gears right when you're cranking hard on it. Which, for you rookies out there, if you don't know, don't crank hard when you're shifting gears. Alright, so it's properly damp out here. I'm gonna take my little shortcut that I know of. We're gonna call it a day.